you for tuning into this Sunday afternoon 2K Sports edition of the NBA. We'll watch the Miami Heat in this one as they go up against the New Orleans Pelicans. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Brent Berry. From the sideline, we'll have David Aldridge. We'll be hearing from him in just a moment. DA, it's all yours.
Thank you, Kevin. Tyler Hero was the 2022 Sixth Man of the Year. He says he patterns his game after another 6'5 guard out of Kentucky who was taken with the 13th pick. Hero said, "All I watch is Devin Booker, just picking things out of his game and trying to work on it. I think I'm capable of doing what he does if I continue to improve." Big goals, Kevin. Big goals.
Big goals are good, though, especially for a kid like Hero who can go as high and as far as he wants to. Good stuff. Good model. David, thanks. Now, the opening lineup for the New Orleans Pelicans. Ingram in the front court with Williamson. Then there's Jonas Valanciunas. Then there's C.J. McCollum. And it's Daniels in at the two guard. And for the Heat, the forwards are Oladipo and Butler. Vincent is out there with Tyler Hero. And it's Adebayo in at the five.
Well, there's been some interesting moves in the Bayou, and this team has set up a roster that I think has some great potential. And there's a lot of talent, a lot of interesting players that are on this roster, and I'm excited for their future.
Now here's McCollum. It's hauled in by Bam Adebayo. Butler at the elbow, over Williamson, and that one's good by Butler. Butler's got the game going here with the first basket for the Heat.
Kind of fun when you have a fast break where guys want to join you, and Jimmy Butler, he's a member of the party.
Ingram finds Williamson. That's good, and it's Ingram with the assist. You definitely saw New Orleans making calculated moves, Brent, in the draft.
Yeah, there's some perfect fits alongside what a healthy Zion Williamson will bring to the court. And so if he's in there making that impact, there's a lot of complementary skill sets on this roster that will elevate them to being much more competitive sooner than you think.
Now Ingram, after Jimmy Butler missed from long range. McCollum passes to Daniels. Back to McCollum. Just five to shoot. Miami grabs the miss. They want to keep it rolling here following the win against Dallas.
Well, you look at the points they produced in that game. Great adjustments on the offensive end.
Yeah, never stopped working. One of those games where just everybody was making shots, continual flow, and a very professional win.
And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
C.J. McCollum, really one of the more unique scorers in the league. And it has a lot to do with the peanut butter smoothness he has, handling the ball, being on great balance, and being one step ahead of the defense.
Free throw, no good. And the way C.J. McCollum, Gray, can get his shot up while moving, that's a big part of his game, isn't it?
Yeah, very few players can shoot as well as McCollum on the run. Applies for his pull-up jumpers or when he's falling out of bounds. McCollum, one of the best in the league at it.
Good on the second free throw. As the season rolls on, Brent, how do squads manage to preserve momentum and energy and keep themselves fired up?
Yeah, you got to challenge yourself, Kevin, to try to continue to be consistently good. And I think that's what you're talking about here, is a standard with which you play is going to help you continue to get wins because you expect that from one another.
Now here's Williamson. Victor Oladipo unable to get his last shot to go. Daniels passes to Williamson, shoots over Hero, and all around the rim that time before dropping in.
Well, the key to defending Zion in the paint is don't let him get the ball. After he touches it, damage is going to get done.
Now here's Butler. He had 10 points in the win against the Mavericks in Dallas.
It was never all about himself. He came away with a lot of assists in that game and just kind of kept everybody in the mix.
And so it's New Orleans with it. After Tyler Hero's miss, Daniels passes to Williamson. Over Vincent. And it's Williamson missing. The Heat trail by three. And the pass to Vincent. Here's Hero trying to end the drought. Bangs home the trifecta.
You could tell Tyler Hero has put some hours in shooting the rock.
Cullen passes to Ingram. And here's Daniels. New Orleans moving it around. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. To be young again.
Makes you nostalgic, doesn't it? Outside, Hero. A three ball. Hero can't get that one to fall. For New Orleans, they've gone 50% from the field, hitting 3 of 6 since the opening tip. Here's McCollum. From the top of the key, he buries it.
And this is part of the patience of C.J. McCollum. In-air adjustments with the defender on him, you have to like that body control.
Ingram against Oladipo. Pass to Hero. Launches it. And that one's good. His second basket of four, shooting 50%.
And a nice sixth sense back there for Hero using that pick and roll.
Cullen passes to Valanciunas. Here's Ingram. Takes a three. It's Adebayo with the rebound. Pass to Butler. Goes straight through the defender for the dunk. Draws the foul. He'll go to the line. It's on Jonas Valanciunas.
Well, Butler's a great competitor, and he's playing with some fire right now.
Boy, a fierce competitor. Jimmy Butler puts his heart and soul into the game.
There are not a lot of opponents or players in this league that are going to outwork Jimmy Butler, and he does. He impacts the game in so many ways, and he's all about winning. Now, Jimmy Butler's just one of those guys that coaching staff and players admire just how competitive he is on a daily basis.
Daniel. Kicks it out to McCollum. Williamson outside. Here's Ingram. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist.
And this is why you just don't want Ingram to establish that kind of deep position on the interior.
Pass to Oladipo. Now Adebayo. To the paint. Here's Vincent. And the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
They've scored several times already here in the first quarter on the inside.
Well, Gabe Vincent is a guy who has not wasted opportunity. He was undrafted back in 2018, but fortunate enough to get a shot in the G League, an opportunity he took full advantage of.
Gabe Vincent, one.
Eventually, Vincent won the G League's Most Improved Player Award.
Well, there were signs that he was league ready, so he rightfully got the call up. And in the first few instances where Gabe Vincent stepped on an NBA floor, he took that confidence with him and now is producing at an NBA level.
Now here's Ingram, coming in off a 41-point performance last game out. Kicks it out to McCollum. Misses the three.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
Butler passes to Hero. Back to Butler. Over McCollum. And Butler gets it to go on the assist from Hero. 7 points for Butler. And so it's McCollum. He'll bring it up for the New Orleans Pelicans. It's a 5-point game. Daniels, a shot. The Pelicans get another chance here, and Williamson gets it to go.
Yeah, Zion bringing it right there, crashing the glass, and relentless energy to get the ball.
Oladipo taking his time here. Vincent, the pass to Oladipo. Shoots over Ingram. Oladipo misses.
That might not be the shot they want him taking, even with the D backing off.
And it's Ingram missing. Miami leading by three. Adebayo passes to Vincent. Oladipo with the ball. Over Ingram. Pelicans with the rebound. Valanciunas has got 5 rebounds tonight. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket. Taking a look here at some numbers for Bam Adebayo. He's been on a remarkable tear this past month, averaging about 18 points per, 9 rebounds, and 2 assists. And you look at the numbers he's been putting up. Fantastic scoring production from him.
Yeah, hard to ask for anything more at this point. He's really stepped up, and he's really delivered.
First free throw is good, and a new group in for the Heat. Yurt Savini's checked in for Bam Adebayo. Daniel Tice comes in for Jimmy Butler. Kayla Martin's checked in for Oladipo. And Strus is subbed in for Gabe Vincent. Both good from the line that time. Heat have gone 6 of 12 from the field here in the first quarter. The pass to Strus. Now, Hero, T right on him. Lock at 6. Here's Martin. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. That one on Nance. This is his first free throw of the game.
Now at the line, Caleb Martin.
He misses the free throw. And he sinks the second. Last outing for the Pelicans. It was a loss to the Magic in Orlando. McCollum dishes to Hayes. Back to McCollum. There's the three. No good that time. And Miami the other way now.
And already they've staked out a noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backboard.
They swipe it. And now the Pelicans on the break. Here's Little. That doesn't go on the chance to tie.
I don't think the defense does enough out there to bother him. I think that one's all on him. Just a flat-out miss.
Pass to Strus. Just 4 to shoot. It's deflected. McCollum deciding where to go with it. Over Yurtsevin. And the basket by McCollum. McCollum's got it all tied up now for the Pelicans. Miami's gone 2 of 4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Now Strus. He's coming off a 10-point game against Dallas. Nance with some nice D. Passes it to Alvarado. Now here's McCollum. Pass to Hayes. And it's out of bounds. The Heat will take it the other way.
Miami ball.
Let's check out some of the best shooting teams out there. Second, the Pelicans.
So patient on the offensive end. I mean, they're not going to force shots, and it's that selectiveness that's yielded such an impressive field goal percentage.
Heat have gone 6 of 14 shooting the ball since the start of the game. Hero passes to Strus. Fires for three. Good D by McCollum. New Orleans has gone 0-4 from three-point land to start out. Looking cold from outside. Here's Little. He's still scoreless so far in this one. And McCollum the bucket on the assist by Hayes. And the Pelicans lead by three.
Well, the coach has confidence in CJ taking that shot, and so CJ has confidence in making it.
And Miami calls their first time out of the game. Their last meeting was in New Orleans, where they were unable to fight off the Pelicans.
Yeah, and what a gut-wrencher it was for them last time they met. Ended up on the losing side in that one.
For your Heat dancer.
The Heat trail by three. Outside, Mark.
Two.
The pass to Tice. Baseline Jay on the way. Count that one.
The mid-range jumper is a high percentage shot for him, and when he's got that much room, forget about it.
Alvarado passes to Hayes. Over Tice. Rebound by the Heat. Outside, Hero. Outside, Mark. 125 left in the first quarter. Good on the triple. Hero's got nine.
Man, he's got that touch working tonight, shooting the ball very well to start this one.
Pass to Alvarado. Back to McCollum. Kicks to Little, lets it go with a three. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum. And the Pelicans lead by one. Outside, Hero. Passes it to Strus. Outside, Hero. Kept alive. Good saving. Count that bucket.
Yeah, they got that one, but early on, it's really been a struggle for them to secure that defensive backboard.
Alvarado passes to McCollum. Latrey. Little gets the bucket. Little's got his second bucket of the game to go.
Man, the triples keep falling, guys. That's three in a row.
Outside, Mark. 7 second difference, shot and game clock. Hero finds Yurtsevin. Lays it up and banks it in. Yurtsevin's got the game tied up here for the Heat.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
Shoots it. Another one falls for New Orleans.
Well, CJ operating like a surgeon out there tonight.
CJ McCollum, he's feeling it tonight and has been the driving force for the New Orleans Pelicans. That quarter had to take a lot out of him. He racked up 12 points. Back right after this.
Okay, fans.
And we hope you're enjoying the game. Both teams tonight keeping things pretty even so far in the scoreboard. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from New Orleans?
Well, in that first quarter, they were intent on just pounding the ball down low.
Yeah, you don't see that all that often, getting down there and doing that much damage in a quarter. You got to respect the game plan.
Adebayo is the big man with Butler slotting in at the four. Max Strus is out there with Vincent, and it's Martin in at the small forward. That's the group in the game for the Heat. Got a piece of it, and he stays with it. Down to five on the shot clock.
All right, a chance to check out stats for Butler.
The past month has been surreal. He's putting up about 21 points per, five assists, and five rebounds. And it says a lot that when we see numbers like this from him, we aren't even shocked. He's that good.
Yeah, we really have just grown to get used to his greatness, and that's the level for him that he's on right now.
And that one misses. You know, Greg, you played on some gritty teams, and we hear that expression, getting punched in the mouth, and it's not usually literal, but what's that look like on the floor? What's it feel like on the court?
Kevin, you're just out hustling and out muscling the team. At times you'll see it, they've kind of checked out mentally, and I'll tell you what, it is one of the best feelings in sport.
New Orleans has gone 3-7 tonight from three-point territory. With a short break in the action, gives us a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Last season, we know the Pelicans made that trade to bring in C.J. McCollum. He says, I think it's a match made in heaven. I'm happy to be here. The cool part is that I haven't had to make any real adjustments. The way I play is the right way. Kevin, back to you.
Well, and he's completely changing teams mid-season. Tough thing to do, but he is a veteran that can certainly handle it. Ball in his hands, good things usually happen. Hey, David, thank you for that story. Throw good, McCollum. Second free throw, no good. Murphy against Butler. Here's Valanciunas again. The Pelicans score.
Punishing inside Valanciunas, getting room to do damage.
Pass to Strus. And we're about a minute into the second quarter of play. Over to the left wing. Six to shoot. They get the rebound. Here's Butler. And the rebound goes to Murphy.
And being that close to the hoop, I thought he had enough room to finish that one.
Here's Ingram. Again, the Pelicans score.
Yeah, and their shooting really starting to pick up here in the second. And you look at the way Ingram can get off a shot. When he gets to his spots, there's just no stopping him. Very few players can create like he can.
Good on the bucket.
That is a tough two right there from Butler. Really his calling card. Rugged play and 100% effort.
Now here's Ingram. Hard to imagine, but the stats are tremendous as he averages close to 27 points a game. Here's Murphy. And the foul on Jonas Valanciunas. That's foul number two for him. And right now, let's watch that terrific swat.
And boy, did he get up quick to reject that shot. That's as fundamental as defense gets.
Victor Oladipo is checked in for Max Strus. And a change for the Pelicans. Williamson's checked in. And it's Butler with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Miami Heat. Trying to get open is Adebayo. That's in. The Pelican lead is cut down to just 2 points with the bucket from Jimmy Butler. A creator indeed, and the name you always hear, Greg, with Ingram as a comparison, Kevin Durant.
And that's about as fair a comp as you'll find. Ingram is special with how he can rise up over defenders with that shot. It makes him a lethal weapon late in the game.
Now Butler. After Brandon Ingram missing on that last three-pointer, Heat moving the ball around. Ingram with the steal. And here's Daniels. He had 15 points last outing. And Murphy kicks to Williamson. Poked loose. Butler with the steal. Can't tie it up as that one misses. The Pelicans have gone 2-of-4 shooting the ball here in the second. And finished off by Williamson.
Yeah, it looks like Zion's got the stage all to himself there, just tearing down the rim.
Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played, and the three ball is good.
You can't just stop when there's a pick set up. Gotta fight over it as a defender.
That's one that the coaches will watch tomorrow with that player. You hate to see him give up in that situation.
And first time out of the game called for New Orleans. Last game matched up with the Magic. Tough loss there.
Yeah, I mean, on the road, their defense was just overrun. Couldn't match the intensity of the opponent, and it cost them.
Well, let's hope there isn't any carryover from that letdown in this one.
Here we go, fans. Time to make some noise for your Heat dancers. Okay, fans, time to get on your feet and make some noise for your Miami Heat dancers. Coming out on the court, your Miami Heat dancers.
And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played, here's Daniels. That one drops for his second bucket. Mark him 2-for-4. The Heat trail by 3. Now the pass to Vincent. And here's Martin. He's guarded by Murphy. Martin dishes to Oladipo. Pass to Vincent. Clock at 4 over Daniels. Vincent misses.
His touch from mid-range, that's almost always good. That won't shake his confidence.
Three with the ball. Butler covering. Ingram against Oladipo. Cuts off the pass. Again, New Orleans turns it over.
Miami ball.
The Pelicans making a switch here. Alvarado's checked in. Butler against Williamson. Butler passes to Oladipo. And the foul on Jonas Valanciunas. And that'll be his third foul so far.
Yeah, looking up at the scoreboard, guys, that's his third foul, and his coach has to consider now sitting him down.
And so here is Miami. Here's Vincent. He's got 6. Passes it to Adebayo. Knocked away. Pass to Ingram. And they call the foul, so he's got the and one chance here to make it a 3-point play. And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for New Orleans.
Right off the bat, they're going after the ball, looking to jump into the passing lanes and create some steals in transition.
Well, one thing that's noticeable is just tremendous energy from everybody, and they put that into their transition play, and all that hustle is paying off.
And that one falls for Ingram.
And while it took Brandon Ingram some time, he has really turned into an incredible player.
Yeah, he's an amazing scorer. He's adding that ability to pass the ball and see the floor. So often you hear about players talking about the game slowing down. But for Ingram, it's getting to a snail's pace. Bam averaged 5 assists per game during that breakout campaign in 2020, and he's at it again.
There's the pass to Ingram. Valanciunas against Adebayo. Here's Ingram. It's hauled in by Bam Adebayo. Adebayo's got 4 rebounds now tonight.
Even if you're not shooting it, you like to see the effort level, and his tonight has been high.
Now, here's Oladipo. He had 16 points in the win against Dallas.
Yeah, but all around offensively, the performance was great. He knew when he had it going, but he also knew he could get other guys going. So his passing right up there on the level with his scoring in that one.
And so it's New Orleans with it. Heat knocking down the tray. Shot clock at 6. Alvarado passes to Williamson. And finished off by Williamson.
Such an important part of Zion's improvement is setting good screens and then being available as a roller.
And the Heat call time here. And as incredible as Zion Williamson has been and is, the big problem, Greg, is keeping him ready to play. His health.
And there have been all sorts of opinions chiming in on whether he can play at a high weight. But the bottom line is something needs to happen to keep him healthy. He's lost too much time early in his career.
Changes. Yurt Savini's checked in for Bam Adebayo. Daniel Tice comes in for Caleb Martin. And Hero subbed in for Vincent. And a change for the Pelicans. Little, he's checked in for Valanciunas. Now here's Butler. 11 points in the game. Over Ingram. Butler, no good. Pelicans leading by 3 to the inside. And the dunk by Williamson.
And Ingram and his court awareness continue to grow. A terrific dime there.
Oladipo outside. Hero passes to Yurtsevin. Ingram with the steal. Over Butler. Again, the Pelicans score.
That's more like it, rounding into form after a very, very difficult first quarter.
Hero kicks to Oladipo. Back to Hero. Here he goes. And he goes strong with the one-handed jam.
In the flash, Tyler Hero makes his way to the inside. Nice use of his athleticism.
Daniels with it. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game. And 2 shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
The Pelicans have gone 5 of 8 from the charity stripe here tonight.
Jose Alvarado, 2.
He's off on the first. And Miami making a change here. Strus is checked in. And a change for the Pelicans. Hayes is checked in for Daniels. He hits the second from the line. And here's Hero. He'll bring it up for Miami. Oladipo outside. Outside, Hero. Rejected by Ingram.
Ingram has that length to still be an effective shot blocker.
Alvarado. The shot that time, not on target. Nice D from Oladipo. The Heat trail by six. Down low, here's Hero. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Hero's got 13.
Hero sticking with it through contact. That's not easy.
Now here's Ingram, defended by Strus. Off with the layup. Shakes off the strong D and gets the bucket for two. Now just a two-point Pelican lead. Ingram passes to Alvarado. New Orleans moving it around. Ingram deciding where to go with it. Six on the shot clock from downtown. No good that time. And the Heat going the other way now. Pass to Strus. He kicks it to Oladipo. But he gets the call and will shoot two. Nasir Little picks one up.
This is where Oladipo goes in and has no fear of drawing some contact. Nice job of getting through the defense.
The Heat shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight. No good on that one.
Probably a little draft in the arena tonight. He's the last guy you expect to miss the mark by that much.
Absolutely. No good at the stripe this time. The second misses also.
This is part of the reason they're down. The free throw line has not been kind to them this quarter.
Well, when Ingram is this aggressive offensively, the ref knows it too.
This is his second trip to the line in this one.
Did he lay an egg at the stripe in their previous game? Couldn't get anything to drop.
And that one falls for Ingram.
I think Brandon Ingram, not only a great story in his own right, starting to find out just how capable he is as a talent in this league, but also for executives about being patient and letting that talent develop.
Both free throws, good for Ingram.
And didn't have a single free throw in that first quarter, but he started to play with a little bit more of an edge to his game here in the second.
Now, here's Oladipo. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. And the shot is good. The Pelican lead has been cut down to two on the bucket from Hero.
Well, the catch and shoot is where Tyler Hero excels.
Passes a little. Here is Nance. To Hayes. Over Tice. Hayes, no good. Miami's gone 5 of 10 from downtown tonight. 50% exactly. Hero kicks to Oladipo. And there's the pass to Tice. Back to Oladipo. and they're unable to get the tying basket there. New Orleans has gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. And slam dunk by Ingram.
Well, he's throwing the defense off balance, and then he gets to the bucket. That's a nice move from Ingram.
Now a timeout called by Miami. For the Heat.
And coach is looking to seize every advantage, maximize every possession.
Got to feel good as a coach if you make all those adjustments. Pull the right strings. That's what they love to do.
Miami Heat dancers.
Tice passes to Oladipo. And here's Strus. And a miss there on the triple.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
And Nasir Little making that look easy.
And here's Hero. He'll bring it up for the Heat. Pass to Strus. Now here's Yurtsevin. Passes it to Hero. Six to shoot. Miami no good on that time either.
Three triples in the first quarter, but he's yet to knock one down here in the second.
Here's Ingram. It's hauled in by the Heat. Hero's got his fourth rebound in this one. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock.
Oladipo, a good free throw shooter, so well served to seek out contact and get to the line.
So far in the game, he's 0 of 2 at the line.
And so far this season, shooting at a 75% clip from the line.
That's good from Oladipo.
The combination of shooting and speed Oladipo provides this team is invaluable. And his hunger to keep getting better, also impressive.
Oladipo hits them both. New Orleans leading by 4. Here's McCollum. And a missed layup.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be because he is so strong in the paint.
And Oladipo has it in the corner. Here's Hero. And no good on the last second attempt this time. And a close game so far through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. New Orleans on top, up by 4. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Jonas, you guys got off to a strong start. How important was it to set the tone early?
You know, we came out with a different energy. He said it's enough to struggle from the start. You know, we got to focus and play good starts.
That is where it all starts. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half momentarily.
Okay, fans, time to get on your feet.
And if you're just joining us, we've played through the first half in a game that's been fairly even so far. The Heat trail by 4. Tipping off the second half, here's Willie Green's five. Up front, it's Williamson at the four, and Valanciunas at the five. Then it's Brandon Ingram. Then there's C.J. McCollum, and it's Daniels in at the two. Shot clock at six. The kick outside to Butler. The three-pointer, no good. Pelicans leading by four. Here's Williamson. It's good again, and the next one, 7-for-8 shooting night so far.
Yeah, these are the kind of indications that the league is worried about if you're an opponent, and you love it if you're on his team. Zion taking over and doing damage.
Oladipo for three, buries it from three-point range. Oladipo's got five.
The D is there, but not present enough. You can't just be there. You gotta disrupt and get in the face of the shooter.
McCollum outside. Pass to Valanciunas. New Orleans moving it around. Now Williamson over Butler. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. Here's Oladipo. The shot will not fall. Good D by McCollum. Pelicans shooting 49% on the game. They'll take that. From about 16, and he knocks down the jumper. He's got 15.
Ingram staying agile, ready to take the shot as soon as that opened up for him.
The pass to Vincent. Here's Adebayo. Oladipo outside. Pass to Hero. Good, and it's Oladipo picking up the assist. Oladipo's got his fourth assist in this one. Cullen passes to Ingram. Daniels with it. Jacks up a three. It's hauled in by Bam Adebayo. Adebayo's got his fifth rebound right now in the game.
And with Bam Adebayo, I mean, we all know how skilled he is as a scorer and how athletic he is as well, but what about his passing?
Well, as much as I want to compliment Bam and his abilities to do that, I have to give some credence here to the coaching staff leaning into that ability that Bam has. They trusted he's going to make good decisions in the half court, and that has opened up a lot of things for them offensively.
Now Daniels passes it to McCollum. Hits the three-point bomb.
C.J. McCollum.
McCollum's got 16.
Well, that's a go-to for C.J. He looks to spray it from three-point line as much as he possibly can.
Pass to Vincent. Adebayo against Valanciunas.
New Orleans foul.
Martin's checked in for the Heat.
First team foul.
Now in the game, Caleb Martin.
And that kind of stifling effort on defense needs another look.
And big defensive plays like that will help them stay in control of this one.
Hero from long range. Again, the miss by the Heat.
Well, the D really getting away with one there. No one on him. And that's going to be good 9 out of 10 times.
Here is Daniels. He's covered by Hero. Daniels, no good. The Heat trail by six. Here's Adebayo. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Adebayo on the inside knows he has to go up hard. He's going to get hit, and he forces the D to do it that time.
The Heat have hit six free throws in 10 attempts.
And how about as a group, 80% on the season, one of their best attributes.
And he makes the first.
And the Adebayo experiment has been pretty awesome to watch just because it's gone nuclear. All the skills and his hard work paying off now.
And And so he makes both from the line. We've gone about 3.5 minutes into the third now. Ingram passes to Daniels. Here's Alvarado. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. Shot clock at 5. Daniels. And he's finally able to knock one down. Daniels has got 6.
How about that move? You'll see very few players able to pull off. Just sensational stuff.
And there's the pass to Ingram. And here's Daniels. He's got 6. Yep, that one goes in there. Daniels has got the lead up to 8 now for the Pelicans. Let's look at the energy stats, how the hustle game has been going for the Pelicans.
And they've shown great focus on the defensive end, putting constant pressure on the ball and really disruptive in terms of what they've done defensively.
We also have to admire the way they've gotten out and run in transition. And they've run wide, they've run their lanes, they've been doing it with a great pace. And that's produced some easy scores.
And that one's good, Ingram.
Yeah, how about the percentage they're shooting from beyond the arc here in the second half?
Outside, Hero. Got a piece of it. Daniels with it. Picked up by Hero. Daniels with it. 8 points for him. Pass to Alvarado. From deep. And it's Miami with the rebound. Hero's got 5 rebounds tonight. Here's Vincent. 6 points for him. Four on the clock. Butler kicks to Martin. Good, and Butler gets the assist. He's got 9.
That's the kind of D that you're not going to find success with, guys. They've got to get a hand in the face.
Pass to Murphy. Now Daniels fires from deep. Hits it from 3-point range. And the Pelicans lead by 11.
And I like the back and forth here, showing confidence from range.
It seems like they're going to find out who can make the deepest threes. Right now, it's a shootout.
Timeout called, the Heat.
Yeah, you can't make any excuses right now for them giving the ball up as much as they have in this one. Hopefully, they can get on the same page during this timeout.
Some changes here for the Heat. Yurtseveni's checked in for Butler. And Strus is subbed in for Tyler Hero. The Heat trail by 11. And that's out of bounds. Miami will retain possession.
Miami ball.
In the post. The pass to Yurtseven. Goes back up. He takes it up and lays it in. Yurtseven's got 6 points.
Almost an impossible shot to block in the post. The defender can't give up that much of a height advantage and expect to contest it.
Now here's Little. 8 points for him. On the wing, Daniels. Just 5 on the clock. Shoots over Strus. And there's Daniels. That's good on the assist by Little.
And for Little, that's a quality find right there, just dropping that pass.
Into the lane. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
First personal foul. Third team foul.
And these are his second and third free throws tonight.
This season, 88% on the line, so he has been in a comfort zone.
That free throw missing. Manu Ginobili recently inducted into the Basketball Hall of Fame, and you won a couple rings with that guy. Give us some memories you can share about the great Ginobili.
Oh, man. Manu is absolutely one of my favorite teammates of all time, Kevin, and one of the most delightful people that you ever could be around. I just think about the practices and the plane rides and him just joking around, and then something happens. He gets on the floor. It gets into the fourth quarter. It's time to win. And it's basically Manu Ginobili time. So I'm thrilled that he's in the Hall of Fame, and he deserves every bit of it.
Pass to Alvarado. No good with the triple. The Heat trail by 11. Here's Vincent. He has six. Outside, Martin. Pass to Yurtseven. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Yurtseven's got 8 points.
Well, if you're giving up that much height, the only thing that you can do as a defender is to foul him.
Here is Daniels, defended by Strus. Daniels passes to Alvarado. Top of the key jumper, no good.
Pretty lax defense there. He's going to see fewer and fewer chances if he can't bury those kind of jumpers.
And here is Strus. He gives his team some nice contributions, averaging a bit over 10 points a game. Daniels from outside. That's his sixth field goal today, and that makes him now 6 for 11.
No doubt about the consistency when it comes to scoring the basketball for him tonight. A real nice lift for their offense.
Good ball movement here by the Heat. Outside, Martin. Clock at six. Here's Vincent. Good saving. And he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
Just a terrific effort on the offensive glass. That's how they're going to cut into this lead.
And Greg, a dunk like that is sure to give them a spark. Time now to turn to our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David.
Thanks very much, Kevin. Not that long ago, of course, the analytical team shot way more three-pointers, and they found a temporary edge. But now every team shoots a lot of threes, and it's more about personnel. When it's a superstar shooting the ball, that mid-range jumper can be very efficient. Guys?
And D.A., we see it all the time. Brandon Ingram with the New Orleans Pelicans. KD. The two players in Phoenix with Chris Paul and Devin Booker. DeRozan in Chicago. They'll hit those all day long. David, thank you. The free throw drops for Little.
Lots of intrigue around Nasir Little and how it is that his game is going to evolve since entering the league. He's consistently worked on developing all of his abilities, shooting, defense, rebounding. The sky's the limit here.
Victor Oladipo, he's checked in for Gabe Vincent. That's also good. So he hits both free throws. The Heat trail by 12. Oladipo, the pass to Martin. Back to Oladipo. Now, here's Strus. He's covered by Daniels. To the left wing. The wide-open shot by Little. And again, New Orleans has no luck. Outside, Martin releases. Nance with the rebound. New Orleans leading by 12. Here's Daniels. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
third personal foul.
For New Orleans, second, they have made 10 of their 14 tries at the free throw line in the game.
Line for the Pelicans.
And 75% on the season as a unit from the free throw line.
First free throw is good. Heroes checked in for Daniel Tice. C.J. McCollum, he's checked in for the Pelicans. Both free throws good from Daniels. Hero with it. He's got 17. Oladipo outside. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
New Orleans foul. Daniel. Third personal foul. Team foul.
This is his third trip to the free throw line.
Now at the line, Victor Oladipo.
Two.
First one falls for. Williamson is checked in for New Orleans. Oladipo hits them both. So it's the Pelicans now. They'll host the Denver Nuggets after this one. And that's the first game in a string of three straight at home. Passes it to Alvarado from outside the arc. And it's Drews with the rebound.
Well, if he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
And the basket by McCollum. McCollum's got the lead up to 14 now for the Pelicans.
Well, there's some confidence from CJ right there. Just so comfortable, even under pressure. Hard to stop when he gets into the paint.
Hero finds Martin. Oladipo outside. Goes up on the wing. Count the basket. Oladipo's got 7 points for the quarter.
And you like to see since the half now, he's finally starting to come around.
Here's Alvarado. Six to shoot. Rebound by the Heat. Yurtsevin's got 8 rebounds in this game.
A struggle for him tonight, but if they can make this lead hold up, they can just chalk this up as one of those nights.
Pelicans leading by 12. Nance passes to Little. Now McCollum defended by Strus. And McCollum the bucket on the assist by Little. McCollum's got 21 in the game.
Well, the shot starts with a good, strong base. That gives McCollum the foundation to hit shots well behind the arc.
Outside, Hero. Over McCollum, and the jumper falls for him. He's got 19.
And Hero getting to the spots where he can be very effective. That swagger he plays with is infectious.
And so it's the New Orleans Pelicans looking at a 13-point lead heading into the next quarter. They've got a big advantage in the turnover stats because of their intense defense. We'll get right back to the action when we return. And now let's go back to a play from earlier as we show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And definitely deserving of the prize tonight. How about the read he made here? Looking like a point guard, putting the pass right on the money.
So helpful to the offensive versatility when your bigs can create, freeing everybody up, and that cut was wide open.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. The forwards are Oladipo and Butler. Yurts have been out there with Tyler Hero. And it's Adebayo in at the center, filling out the middle. That's the group on the floor for Miami. There's the pass to Oladipo. Now, Yurts have been outside Hero. From the high post. Good D by McCollum. Pelicans leading by 15. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a three-point play chance here for him.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside. And there had been so much talk about Zion wanting out of New Orleans. That was all put to rest this past summer. Zion signing a loaded extension to keep him with the Pelicans for the next handful of years.
Gabe Vincent, he's checked in for Miami. Daniels, he's checked in for the Pelicans.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Vincent, the pass to Hero. Here's Vincent. He is guarded by McCollum. Here's Vincent, out to the right wing. Trying to get open is Butler. Unable to get that one. Nice D from Valanciunas. Here's Daniels. From 13 feet, it goes down. And the Pelicans lead by 20.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Here's Hero. No good. They had a chance to end the run there. And so it's Ingram who brings up the ball for New Orleans. They lead by 20. It's the most we've seen. And yes, it's good.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Coaching staff probably most proud of the effort of this team on both ends of the floor here tonight.
Here's Oladipo, and the shot goes down. Oladipo's got 9 points now in just the second half.
Oladipo so strong and scoring, even with the D kind of knocking him around a bit on that play.
Ingram kicks to McCollum. Here's the floater. Vincent with the rebound. The Heat trail by 20. Butler passes to Vincent. Ingram against Oladipo. Pass to Hero. Good, and it's Oladipo picking up the assist. Oladipo's got 5 assists in the game.
From Victor Oladipo.
Pass to Daniels. Dishes to Williamson. Now here's Ingram, guarded by Oladipo. Ingram against Oladipo. Ingram kicks to Daniels. Great D that time from Hero. Miami's gotten the three-point shot off 16 times tonight. 7 times they've hit it, 9 times they've missed. That one drops for him.
Oladipo playing a couple years at point guard in Orlando when he started his career, showing off his passing ability there.
Back to McCollum. Now here's Valanciunas. Knocks it loose. It's stolen by Adebayo. Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Back to Oladipo. 5 on the clock. Shoots. And the rebound goes to the Pelicans.
Well, his poor shooting is a big reason that they're staring at this deficit right now. He needs to get on track. They're going to find a way to win.
And boy, he's really in a groove. Dominant performance last game. Same thing this time out.
Seems to be nobody standing in his way. No roadblocks for him to get to his spot, capitalize, and continue to be aggressive.
Pass to Adebayo. Outside, Hero. Pelicans pull it in. Daniels has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Here's McCollum. Lead pass was put in just the right spot. And now it's 27 points for C.J. McCollum. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill. You know, he was a non-factor in that first half, but now he's making up for lost time.
Now the pass to Daniels. Back to McCollum over Vincent. And it's good off the back of the rim and in.
Assist goes to
McCollum's got 16 points here in the second half. Inside. And foul on the shot. So he'll get a chance at the line. It goes on C.J. McCollum. The NBA announced its 75th anniversary team last year, Brent, with a lot of fanfare attached to it. What'd you think of the list?
I thought the list was pretty good. You can always argue a few guys should have been on it, and it's probably a tough pill to swallow for current guys who have had tremendous careers to this point, guys who have played 8 or 9 years that didn't maybe make this particular list. I'll tell you this, Kevin. In 25 years, there'll be another list.
And the first one at the line is good. Good on both. Now a timeout called by New Orleans.
Timeout. Okay, Heat fans, show some love for your Heat dancers.
And so it's New Orleans with it. McCollum kicks to Daniels. Pass to Ingram. Shoots the three. The shot's good on the assist by Daniels. Daniels has got his fifth assist in this one. The Heat trail by 21. Oladipo, the pass to Hero. Back to Oladipo. Adebayo against Valanciunas. Up top, Hero over Daniels. And again, it's the Heat missing.
He's been off the mark, and that hasn't helped them chip away at the lead. It's been a theme here this quarter.
The feed to Valanciunas. Shoots over Hero. Again, the Pelicans score.
Not just a threat in the paint, Valanciunas showing the soft touch.
Pass to Hero. To the middle. The kick out to Oladipo. Butler against Williamson. He had to fade back on that one, but still got it to go.
Disappointing as a player to have such a great game and still be trailing. Not over yet, though.
Passes to Valanciunas. Over Adebayo. And there's Valanciunas on the assist from Ingram. Ingram's got his fourth assist in this one. Here's Vincent. He's guarded by McCollum. And the pass to Adebayo. And for a while there, Greg, it seemed like we were entering the super team era. But lately, homegrown talent. Players you draft and develop or sign and develop seems to be the way teams are going.
Yeah, and it's not easy to maintain a culture when you're bringing in stars from outside. We've seen some cautionary examples here of late.
Butler passes to Vincent. Oladipo outside. And the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
And every bit of the body control right there for Adebayo out there going right through the contact.
Fifth personal foul. Second team foul. Now at the line, Bam Adebayo. One.
Pelicans leading by 19 points. Pass to Daniels. Out to the wing. And McCollum now atop the key. Again, the Pelicans score.
Yeah, the awareness and the natural playmaking ability starting to show up in Zion's play.
Pass to Butler. Brent, with the way shooting has evolved, do you think they might move the three-point line further out at some point?
I don't know if that's going to happen anytime soon, but I have heard some great ideas, and who knows?
McCollum passes to Valanciunas. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum. Valanciunas has got 8 points here in this quarter.
An even stronger second half. Tremendous efficiency at the offensive end of the floor.
Here's Vincent, back to Hero. And here's Oladipo, 4 on the shot clock. Here's Adebayo. And it's Ingram with the rebound. Ingram's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
Ingram adding more muscle, a little more moxie each and every year.
Shooting for New Orleans, Brandon Ingram.
And that one falls for Ingram. Both free throws, good for Ingram. And Brent, nowadays there are so many options for the great high school basketball player in this country and overseas. Do you see the G League Ignite and similar ways as a positive overall?
I think right now you'd have to say that the G League Ignite has been a successful experiment, and that run is going to continue. You get guys like Jalen Green, who was drafted by the Houston Rockets and came in, had a sensational rookie season. That pathway has led him there, so I think they're doing a good job. The interesting thing, Kevin, to talk about is what colleges have done in response to that and what's going on in the NIL space. How does that change the dynamic in the future?
And the Heat call time here. C.J. McCollum really making a difference here.
Gotta be using this timeout to think about a personnel change or a game plan change to try to slow him down.
Okay, fans, time to get on your feet and make some noise for your Miami Heat dancers.
And now, let's present our New Balance Player of the Game, C.J. McCollum.
And what an amazing ball game we've seen from him. It's been a one-man show worth the price of admission all by itself. There wasn't anything he couldn't do on that court tonight.
He's been their pulse tonight, the player who's guided them to the win, and it's a win they needed coming off a loss in their last one. Miami's gotten off to a great start from three-point range in the final quarter. They're a perfect 3 of 3. Here's Vincent. He's guarded by McCollum. Ingram against Oladipo. 5 to shoot. Puts up a 3. And again, Miami with the triple.
That's nice focus from Oladipo, not letting the knee get to him, and he sunk a jumper with a guy in his face.
Passes it to Daniels. Now here's Ingram. 1:51 left in the fourth quarter.
It is amazing how good a three-point shooter Jonas Valanciunas has become.
He didn't attempt a 3 in his first 5 years in the NBA, and now he's shooting a ton of them. So he's got great feel, great touch, and it's done a lot to round out his game.
The first one falls. Well, Greg, we're seeing high schoolers now making 6 figures to play basketball. I bet you wouldn't have minded that in your time, would you?
I tell you what, it beats delivering the newspaper, right? It's still fresh and developing, but a lot of different opportunities are emerging.
He's perfect from the line this time.
There are ways to get a guy like Jonas Valanciunas to be aggressive in the game. You got to feed the big man, so get him the ball earlier and get it to him often.
For the 3, and it's Ingram with the rebound. And Ingram has got the ball here for the New Orleans Pelicans. Back to McCollum. 1:24 left in the fourth. Wing shot on the way. Up again. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance, and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for New Orleans.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought, an all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that, and man, they just pretty much blew them right out of the water. A clinic was put on display here today.
And so taking a look at their record, a nice milestone they'll be picking up tonight. 30 wins on the year now.
Really, they had their number this season. 2 wins, a home win, and an away win.
And something we've come to almost expect is greatness from this guy. Such an overall great performance it was for Brandon Ingram.
It felt like there was more than one of him out there tonight. He was involved on every possession, and he made his presence felt in so many ways.
20 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Adebayo with the bucket.
Well, at this point, they're just trying to get back in sync. You want to play a good brand of basketball.
Consistency definitely is a key to some of the playoff performing teams, and tonight they just did not find it in this contest.
McCollum outside, so we see New Orleans taking the W here. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Jonas, you have a lot on you in terms of patrolling the paint. How do you think you're doing?
I feel good. You know, there is a better game. There is a worse game. But, you know, I'm bringing energy every game. I'm fighting. And my job is take rebounds, set a screen. I'm doing that job.
It's grunt work, but you're good at it. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Alden, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. And we'll see you next time.